Hey there, lads and ladies. It is Petrifying Pumpkins here, and welcome to the first video of 2022. I hope you all had a fantastic new year and that you will continue to have a fantastic rest of the year. And of course you will, because this is the year that PSVR 2 is coming out. Couple of quick things. Ignore that bed lying up against the wall in the background. I just don't have the energy to do anything about that right now. Normally I twist the camera so you can't see it, but I don't want to do that anymore. All right, you're just gonna have to put up with the fact that I have a vertical bed. There's no place else to put it. It just has to be there. Okay, I know it's ugly, I know it's low class, and you deserve better, but it is what it is. First video of 2022 is going to start off on the right foot, I think, because we're going to be talking about PSVR 2, which is kind of the only thing I want to talk about, you know, other than Firewall and stuff like that, of course, and great games in general. But, you know, PSVR 2 is the future. It's what we've all been waiting for with bated breath. Learned that in school. We were hoping to have already seen us in December. Apparently, it was supposed to be shown in December, and then plans fell through. So early 2022 is now the estimated time of reveal when we see this thing. And then to be launched at the end of 2022. So what news do we have about it today? We've got some information that it might be entering into actual mass production very soon. This comes from Push Square. So from Sammy Baker, this went up today. Manufacturing tittle-tattle tips PSVR 2 to enter production soon. The word on the social media street is that the next generation PSVR headset will go into production soon. Speculation stems from a Chinese supply chain source who claims a company called Gore-Tek, I think I might be saying that right, maybe, has landed the contract. So the firm previously partnered with PlayStation on its original VR headsets, so there is precedent, it makes a lot of sense that they would do it again, and it also supplies components for the PS5, so it all adds up, you know? So if I sound like I'm a little bit out of breath or something, well, number one, I'm fat. Number two, I've got the COVID, so let me just, I should have put that at the beginning, so currently under the effects of COVID right now, so please forgive me if I'm breathing heavily into the microphone. While the source is somewhat wishy-washy, we've been unable to independently verify the information for ourselves, hence why it's possibly wishy-washy and why we should all take it with a pinch of salt. Gore-Tek is enjoying record share prices, partly due to its collaboration with Meta on the Quest 2 headset. Yuck, disgusting. This is despite ongoing semiconductor shortages around the world, so the results are impressive. Firm expects to post similar results in 2022, with one major Japanese, hint hint, wink wink, partner expected to ship around 1 to 2 million next gen VR headsets later this year. Now who could we possibly think of? Major Japanese partner that will be launching a next-gen headset in 2022. Who could that possibly be? Perhaps Sony? Perhaps PSVR 2? Absolutely, that's what it is. This is almost certainly referring to the PlayStation and gives us a rough indication of how many units the platform holder plans to prepare for launch. So that's important. 1 to 2 million they plan for launch. It makes sense that the new PSVR headset will be getting ready for mass production if it is still targeting a release this year. So there isn't really much substance to this story beyond things perhaps progressing as planned. So while that does kind of seem like no news is good news, it's still nice to know that it's progressing as planned, you know, because we didn't get that reveal in December that we were hoping. Maybe things could have been knocked back, maybe the headset could be pushed back to 2023, which would be really depressing for us. We previously heard from development sources that a full reveal is scheduled for the start of this year, and that's still the case as far as we're aware. So they've got some sources themselves, developers, then they've been told they'll be revealed at the start of this year. Now, what's the start of this year? January, February, March? I think all those could be considered the start of this year. So sometime in the next 3 months is when I'm expecting to see this, hopefully sooner rather than later, of course. But yeah, that's it for this update video. Nothing earth-shattering or whatever, of course, but, you know, but it's nice to be getting these little crumbs, these little nuggets, you know, to kind of reassure us that everything's on the right path, you know, just one foot in front of the other, and we'll get to PSVR 2 before we know it. So with all that said, let me end this video. Thank you very much for watching. This is the point where I usually shill my Patreon, but I have put my Patreon on ice, at least temporarily, until my output is more consistent on the channel. But I just do want to say that if you are someone who had been supporting me on Patreon, or who had, like, at any point supported me on Patreon or the channel in any way whatsoever, I'm very grateful for that. Thank you very much. You can still help me out the old-fashioned way with the likes, the comments, the shares, and all that usual shit if you want. And finally, let me thank Decepticon for letting me use his music in all of my videos. You can check him out, decepticon.com. Link to him in the description. With that said, please stay nice and moist, and hopefully this bit of information has helped you produce a bit of moisture, you know, for the new year. And once again, Happy New Year. I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.
Petrifying Punk.